After Pac died, Death Row changed drastically, more than you can imagine.
Dr. Dre left first, Pac died. You know, all of those things would have kept us at number one. The music changed, the direction changed. So Snoop had to take the reins, and he had to take on the challenge of holding Death Row on his back and keep going forward.
I seen my cousin Snoop, man. He was like, God, he was sad, man. You know, you could hear in his voice that, you know, I don't want to be here. Nobody wants to be there.
I mean, we all felt like that, you know, because we were Death Row, and that's the life we was living. We felt like we was untouchable until that fatal day.
Getting out of Death Row, I mean, I always think like, yo, I could have very easily have been in that car in Las Vegas. You know what I'm saying? So fortunately for me, I left at the time that I did.
That time, Snoop and Dre were saying that this beef was out of control and that they wanted to squash it.
I will be working with a lot of the artists from the East Coast, a lot of the artists from the West Coast.
Dre's latest release is far from squeaky clean, but it does attempt to soothe rap's raging hardcore rivalries.
The East Coast, West Coast thing, I ain't got a problem with nobody. To me, they better kill it right now, because if it keeps going on, nobody from the East Coast is going to be able to come to L.A. and be safe, and nobody from the West Coast is going to be able to come to the East Coast and be safe.
I'm Snoop Dogg. I never had any beef with anybody from the East. I'm here to make good music. That's what I signed my contract to Death Row Records for, to make good music and perform and put out good albums. I didn't sign a contract to hurt nobody or make people hate me or hate people. It was just to make good music.
Had he joined in on that shit Pac was preaching, that hatred toward the East Coast, he might not be here.
I've been there. I've done that. So I'm going to go this route. You know what I'm saying? Thanks, Dre.
This did not sit well with Suge, because Snoop would not take his side in this beef. Snoop tried to stay neutral, and Suge demanded loyalty.
Either motherfuckers riding with us, or they riding against us. Ain't no in between. Either you with us or against us. Those who are not with us, you have nothing.
Snoop was growing wary of Suge Knight in this time. There were rumors that Suge had something to do with Tupac's death. Snoop believed this and started taking precautions for himself.